God says,
I'll be committed to you. I'll never leave you. Nothing in this world could make me walk away. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what you face, you won't be lonely. Because forever is a long time. That's how long I'll love you.
God, we thank you for this day that you've given us, another opportunity to be able to allow the light to shine upon our faces one more time. We also thank you for this day to be able to delve deeper into your word. We ask and invite your Holy Spirit to give us ears to hear something we've never heard before. Give us eyes to see something we've never seen before. Give us hearts to feel something we've never felt before. Great God that you are, have your way with us as we wrestle with the biblical text together. Will you invite your Holy Spirit to rest on Dr. Crutchfield as he provides us the lesson for this morning. Continue to bestow your blessings upon each and every one of us as we draw closer to you. This we pray in the mighty name of Jesus, our risen Lord and Savior. Amen.
Genesis chapter 13. I will begin reading at verse 8 from the Common English Bible. Abram said to Lot, "Let's not have disputes between me and you and between our herders, since we are relatives. Isn't the whole land in front of you? Let's separate. If you go north, I will go south. And if you go south, I will go north." Lot looked up and saw the entire Jordan Valley. All of it was well irrigated, like the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt. As far as Zoar, this was before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. So Lot chose for himself the entire Jordan Valley. Lot set out towards the east, and they separated from each other. Abram settled in the land of Canaan, and Lot settled near the cities of the valley and pitched his tent close to Sodom. The citizens of Sodom were very evil and sinful against the Lord. After Lot separated from him, the Lord said to Abram, "From the place where you are standing, look up and gaze to the north, south, east, and west, because all the land that you see I give you and your descendants forever. I will make your descendants like the dust of the earth. If someone could count the bits of dust on the earth, then they could also count your descendants. Stand up and walk around through the length and breadth of the land, because I am giving it to you." So Abram packed his tent and went and settled by the oaks of Mamre in Hebron. There he built an altar to the Lord.
Greetings. As we begin a new quarter, the fall quarter of 2024, September 1, 2024, making transitions, or Abram builds an altar at Mamre. From Genesis 13:8-18 is our text that we're using, and our focus is throughout the life, threshold opportunities arise that determine our future. How do we honor such opportunities with solemnity and gratefulness? Abraham built altars to mark those occasions on which God called him to greater faithfulness. The goals for the learner are to explain the context of Abraham's worship with regard to altars, to desire the spiritual maturity that develops through acknowledging God's activity in our lives, to practice a worshipful response and recognition of God's presence and activity in the threshold moments in our lives. Abram's generous offer to Lot in verses 8 through 9. So Abram said to Lot, "Please let there be no strife between you and me and between my herdsmen and your herdsmen, for we are brothers. Is not the whole land before you. Please separate from me. If you take the left, then I will go to the right. Or if you go to the right, then I will go to the left. Since Abram was the eldest and God gave all the land to Abram, not to Lot, it was pure generosity on Abram's part that caused him to make this offer to Lot. Abram was able to fight when the occasion demanded it. He did not yield to Lot out of weakness, but out of love and trust in God. A few acres of grazing land didn't seem worth fighting for to a man who lived with an eternal perspective. God was glorified when Paul, out of love, waived his right to be supported by the gospel in 1 Corinthians 9:14 through 18. God was glorified when Jesus, out of love, waived his right to an existence that knew no human suffering or trial by experience in Philippians 2, 5 through 11. Abram fulfilled the New Testament principle of love. Let each of you look out not only for his own interest, but also for the interest of others in Philippians 2, 4. If you go to the right, then I will go to the left. Right or left, Abram knew he could trust God. He did it because he learned God would provide for his needs, and he did not have to worry about being too generous. Abram knew whatever Lot chose, God would make sure Abram prospered. In Egypt, Abram thought he had to take his fate into his own hand. He had to look out for himself. Now he was wiser and was willing to let God look out for his interest. Right or left, it didn't matter to Abram because God would be there because he trusted in God. Abram did not have to be obsessed with his own rights, and neither do we. Everything we receive is the free gift of God and has nothing to do with our concept of rights. Lot chooses his portion of land in verses 10 through 13. And Lot lifted his eyes and saw all the plain of Jordan, that it was well watered everywhere before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, like the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt as you go through Zoar. Then Lot chose for himself all the plain of Jordan, and Lot journeyed east. And they separated from each other. Abram dwelt in the land of Canaan, and Lot dwelt in the cities of the plain, and pitched his tent even as far as Sodom. But the men of Sodom were exceedingly wicked and sinful against the Lord. Lot made his choice purely based on what he could see with his eyes. He cared only for the material abundance of the land and cared nothing for how it would impact him and his family spiritually. As much as anything, faith means we do not walk by what we see, but by what we know to be true in God. For we walk by faith, not by sight, 2 Corinthians 5:7 teaches us. Abram walked by faith, Lot walked only by sight. Pitched his tent even as far as Sodom. It was only this far for now, but later Lot became a leader of this sinful city, valuing only the things can be seen, increased his wealth temporarily. But Lot would eventually lose it all. Of course, Lot thought, I can serve God as well as there as here. They probably need a witness, but he deceived himself as many since then have done. Jeremiah 7:9 states, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know the heart? In the end, he who sought this world lost it, and he who was willing to give up anything for the honor of God found it. It wasn't Lot's choice that led his heart astray. His heart was already astray, and it was demonstrated by his choice. God confirmed God's promise to Abram in verses 5:14 through 15. God promises the land to Abram and to his descendants forever. And the Lord said to Abram, after Lot had separated from him, lift your eyes now and look from the place where you are, northward, southward, eastward, and westward. I give you and what you see, for all the land which you see, I give to you and your descendants forever. God wanted to talk to Abram alone after Lot left. This was a promise made to Abram, not to Abram's nephew. This promise of the land had been made to Abram when he lived in Ur of Chaldeans, and we find that in Genesis 12. God now repeated the promise. God also wanted to remind Abram that even though Abram had been generous enough to grant some of the land to his nephew Lot, God still said the land belonged to Abram. God reminds Abram of his promise to give Abram many descendants. That's in verse 16. And I will make your descendants as the dust of the earth, so that if a man can number the dust, if a man can number the dust of the earth, then your descendants also could be numbered. I will make your descendants as the dust of the earth. This was quite a promise to make to a childless man in his 70s or 80s. Yet Abram knew to walk by faith and not by sight. Your descendants, again, this promise of many descendants was made to Abram when he lived in Ur of the Chaldeans. To assure Abram, God repeated the promise. And then in the last two verses of our lesson, Abram walks through the land God gave to him. Arise, walk in the land through its length and its width, for I give it to you. Then Abram moved his tent and went and dwelt by the terebinth trees of Mamre, which are in Hebron, and built an altar there to the Lord. Arise, walk in the land through its length and width, for I give it to you. As a token of Abram's reception of the land by faith, God wants Abram to explore the land of promise, to walk through it as if it were his, though he did not have a record of ownership to the land yet. In the same way, God wants us to explore a land of promise for us, his word, where God has given to us exceedingly great and precious promises. 2 Peter 1 and 4 teaches us where he has given us all the things that pertain to life and godliness. God wants us to walk through this land, possessing it by faith. Dwelt by the terebinth trees of Mamre, which are in Hebron. The name Mamre means vision. Hebron means communion. Abram once again walked in the Lord's vision for him and in communion with the Lord, and built an altar there to the Lord. Abram built another altar. He lived life in constant awareness of the need for a sacrificial atonement and covering. I now commend to you the challenges on the next slide. This is our lesson for today. The challenges on the next slide. God bless you and God keep you on this September 1st. God bless you.
Light in the darkness. Declare it and say it. Promise, light in the darkness. Oh my. Everybody, let's say it. Say, Waymaker. You're the light in the dark.